So welcome guys for another video. In this one, I'll give you a walkthrough on how to set up a professional email address using G Suite. So I've already created a website and bought a domain. So I'll be using that domain name that I bought for setting my professional email address up. Okay, to access G Suite, we can Google it or access it on this link provided on the screen. However, I clicked on the pricing so that you know the different prices of the plans G Suite offers. First, there is the basic plan, which is the $6 per month. And second, the business plan, which is $12 per month. And third, there is the enterprise plan, which is $25 per month. You're free to select whatever plan you want. For me, to start my online business, all I need from G Suite is a professional email address, so I'll go with the basic plan, that is the $6 per month. It is cheap and already has whatever I need. So next, you will be directed to this page where G Suite welcomes you and tells you to get started. It tells you that your 14 days trial does not require a software to download, so I'll go and put my business name. And for now, there's only me in my business, and so I'll choose just the option, just you. Country is already placed, and I'll click on next. Next, you'll be asked for your contact information, so fill as appropriate, and after that, click on next. Next, you will be asked if your business already has a domain or not. So since I'm using the domain name of my website, I'll click on the option, yes, I have one. I can use. If you don't have a domain name, click on the no, I need one option, and you'll be given easy instructions to follow on how you can buy a new domain name. Next, you will be asked your business domain name that you'll be using as a professional email address. After that, after you've inserted yours, click on next, and on the next page, you'll be shown your domain and click on next to set up your account. This one I'll click yes, but you can choose the next option if you want. Now, on the next page, you'll choose the name that will be in front of your professional email and choose your password. So fill in as appropriate, and after that, do read their terms and conditions and click on agree and continue. On the next page, you'll be able to review your basic plan. And in my case, I'll choose currency as dollars. And as you can see, it's $5.40 per month. It also tells you when will the payment be effected each month. And as an introductory price, the $5.40 will be available for only 12 months only. And it will go back to $6 per month after that. Next, you'll be directed to your review and checkout page. Do enter your appropriate information, such as name, address, and your card number for billing purposes. It seems I was having an issue because I was using my prepaid card and Google was not accepting payment via prepaid cards, so I had to get myself a credit card for that. And now the G Suite account has been successfully created, and now we'll click on the continue to setup button, and you should get a pop-up where you are welcome to the admin console. The admin console will contain your information like the username you will be using to log in into your account, the subscription package you are using, and the date when your trial period will end. Just click on next, and after that we will need to carry out some steps to fully set up our G Suite account. So first of all, we will need to verify our domain name, and after that, which I don't find necessary, is to create email account, so we can skip that. And the final and important step is to actually activate Gmail for our professional email address. So we will go on with the first step and click on verify. We will then be directed to this page here, where it describes to us how the process works. So first of all, we will need to do a TXT verification, where we need to add a verification code to our domain settings. They will verify if we have added the code successfully, and after verification, we can start using G Suite. You don't have to worry about anything, just follow through with me and click on continue. On the next page, you will be given elaborated instructions on what you need to do. In summary, we just need to copy the TXT record code provided to the domain host website. It is the website where we created our domain name. So in my case, it's Bluehost, and I'll go on and sign myself in and a new tab. Okay, next, you can copy the code that was provided, and you need to find your DNS records. Just follow through with me. Once you've signed in your domain host website, just click on the domains tab, and you will need to select the domain which you have created an account for. In my case, I only have one domain, so it's already selected. Click on the manage tab of the domain you want to select. Then on the left hand side of the screen, under the domains tab, click on the zone editor tab to get access to the page where we need to paste our code. Next, we need to follow the instructions on how to actually paste the code. So in the DNS zone editor page, you will find a field next to the host record. It should be the at symbol. The TTL field should stay the same, and the type field should be changed to TXT, and the code should be pasted. Now to confirm, if we scroll down, we will find the TXT table, and it should appear like this. Now we will proceed with the adding of the TXT code. After the TXT code has been added, if we scroll down, we will find a table similar to this. And this shows that the record has been successfully created. And we will now go to the G Suite page to verify our domain. And if we click on verify, it will usually take up to 1 hour for the verification to complete. After the verification is complete, we'll be returned to this page. As I said before, we can skip the second step and activate Gmail for our domain. In this next page, we'll just have to check these two boxes and click on continue. So the next page will give us the detailed steps we need to carry out to activate our Gmail. So the first three steps tell us to open our domain host, which in my case is Bluehost. And since it's already open, and in the DNS zone editor page, we'll go on and check the fourth step. The fourth step tells us to delete an old MX setting. So we'll go on and delete it. So delete. Okay. And it's loading. And if we check in the MX table, it's deleted. So let's check the other steps. Now we need to do an entry by copying the code, and pasting it over to the DNS zone editor page. So we'll follow the instruction and do this. The host record field should have the at symbol, the TTL field should be left the same, and the type field should be changed to MX, and the code should be pasted in the points to field, and the priority should be set to 1. And then we click on add record, and it's loading again. After it's finished, if we scroll down, we can see a new record is added in the MX table. So let's continue on with the next steps. We'll need to add 4 more records by repeating the same steps. So let's continue on adding them. After the 4 records have been added, you should get a table similar to this one. So it will take some time for the server to be updated. After 5 minutes or so, do activate your Gmail. So it usually takes about 1 hour or so for the activation to be complete. So we'll wait for that. After the activation, you will be directed to the login page of Gmail. So your login, and do check actually if your G Suite account is working properly by sending yourself an email to your personal email address as a test. Mine is working perfectly. So guys, here is how you set up a professional email address on a G Suite account. And if you got value, please do smash that thumbs up button and subscribe. And please don't forget the notification bell, because so that you can follow up with what will come next. And guys, for any confusion or questions, feel free to leave me a comment and tell me about it. It's been fun. See you on the next video. Bye-bye.